We are also clubbing up vocational skill training. So I will be very brief because I'm trying to only highlight the areas where we can work together. I am always available here. So any of you anytime want to discuss separately and think how, you are always welcome. But then the areas that can be also can be vocational skill, where if you have some presence in some districts, some of your branches or some of your offices, there it can be collaborated and expertise can be given. Definitely the management of the centers. There are so many centers that we have to run. You have already opened 18,000 centers before the launching, and there will be many more. So district-wise, they will be there. We have volunteers. Ma'am, I have always felt that the volunteers that we are appointing, there must have been quite a lot of wisdom in deciding that, but we are not paying them anything, as you know. Maybe that is one area where the corporates can help us. We have village coordinators who are really supervising over the volunteers who are teaching at the grassroots level the non-literate persons. But then I am feeling a little uncomfortable that how do you convince them all the time because we are not paying and they are poor village people. Maybe there somewhere you can adopt some of the centers, and in that adoption it can also be the remuneration or honorarium for the volunteers. Definitely areas will also be soft issues. It is always not financial. Issues will be also, you know, motivating the non-literate persons. Quite, it's a challenging task. It's the most difficult task. It's not like sending children to school. Today we all know that children have to go to school. But today adults come up and ask that, why do I have to learn? What am I going to gain out of it? I'm happy doing my farming. I'm happy doing my other work. But then that kind of, you know, talking mobility, community mobilization, that it is for self-development, it is for exposure, it is for knowing the world, it is for prestige in the village and all that, we have to really build in all these. So that is another area where I think we need large lot of support. We have our, it's not that we want to abdicate our responsibility, but I have always been feeling that education is not a sectoral job. Education has to be owned by everyone, each one of us. It's not a project. Because just like we cannot think of not sending our children to school or grandchildren to school, and we are concerned, all of us in our individual, we are concerned about education. Similarly, that feeling has to be extended to the community. And therefore, it has to be a kind of, it is an area where everyone can chip in. Though this is for Sakshar Bharat, let me say a few words about the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. All of you are aware of the Right to Free and Compulsory Education Act. It has come. All children between 6 and 14 have to go to school. That means no children should be out of school. There are quite a few number of projects. I don't want to elaborate. But in this area, already corporates are working. Some of them are working because they have come forward to adopt schools. They have come forward to give uniforms, kits. They have come forward to construct additional classrooms. They have come forward to supervise. So Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan is another area where throughout the state we are doing it. We are still short of classrooms. Government of India is spending substantial money, but the need is so great. RT mandate is so different. Like, you know, you have to have a primary school within 1 kilometer of the habitation. The teacher-student ratio has gone up. So since there, that's why there is a tremendous kind of need for additional classrooms, need for learning materials, need for assessment of learning outcome. We are not only talking of universalization, we are also talking of quality, and we have to balance both. So this is another area where a lot of corporate partnership will be welcome. And I find generally that many want to help in two fields, health and education, because everyone knows these are important. These are touching the lives of rural people. These really can go, that kind of expertise, that kind of, you know, communication that is required there, this can be delivered by all of you. Though it may sound like a cliche, but still, today I feel that what Vivekananda told 100 years back is still correct, that as long as there is one illiterate person in this country, I call every educated person a traitor. Thank you.